Article 110 deals with definition of money bills. A bill shall be deemed to be a money bill if it contains only provisions dealing with all or any of the following matters. A. The imposition, abolition, remission, alteration or regulation of any tax. B. The regulation of the borrowing of money or the giving of any guarantee by the Government of India, or the amendment of the law with respect to any financial obligations undertaken or to be undertaken by the Government of India. C. The custody of the Consolidated Fund or the Contingency Fund of India. The payment of money into or from any such fund. D. The appropriation of money out of the Consolidated Fund of India. E. The declaration of any expenditure to be expenditure charged on the Consolidated Fund of India, or the increasing of the amount of any such expenditure. F. The receipt of money on account of the Consolidated Fund of India, or the public account of India, or the custody or issue of such money, or the audit of the accounts of the Union or of a state. G. Any matter incidental to any of the matters specified in subclause A to F. A bill shall not be deemed to be a money bill by reason only that it provides for the imposition of fines or other pecuniary penalties, or for the demand or payment of fee for licenses or fee for services rendered, or by the reason that it provides for the imposition, abolition, remission, alteration or regulation of any tax by any local authority or body for local purposes. If any question arises whether a bill is a money bill or not, the decision of the Speaker of the House of the People thereon shall be final. Every money bill shall be endorsed when it is transmitted to the Council of States under Article 109 and when it is presented to the President for assent under Article 111. The certificate of the Speaker of the House of the People signed by him that it is a money bill.